Good day to all of you. In the last class, we learned about some of the options of the toolbar like font name, font size, bold, italic, and underline, etc. We also learned about where they are used. So, do you all remember what was taught to you in the previous class? Before we begin today's class, let us revise what we learned in the previous class. Can you tell what is software? Software is a program that can be installed in a computer and used as required by us. Can you tell what is the other name for a writer file and in how many ways can we open the writer file? Writer is also known as text document, and we can open this in many ways. What is formatting tool? With the help of formatting tool, we can make many changes on the desired text, like change the writing style, size, bold, italic, underline, color change, etc. What are text boundaries? The text boundaries help us in typing the text within the writer page. How many arrow keys are there and what are they used for? Arrow keys are of four kinds and we use these to move our cursor from one place to another on the writer page. Go ahead now and switch on your computer and open the writer file. If you have any problems in opening the writer file, watch the video carefully and learn how to do it. Today, we learn a new method to open files by watching a video. Firstly, you will need to locate on the desktop the file which is named as an OpenOffice file or search for its symbol as is being shown in the video. Now, you should also look for a similar symbol on your desktop. Take your pointer there and then using the left button of the mouse or the touchpad, double click on the symbol. On doing this, just as is being shown in the video, a window will open up in front of you. You will see many components of OpenOffice being shown in the window. This window is called the Quick Start window. Here, to select the text document, just once click on it with the left button. This will open your OpenOffice writer file. In today's class, all of you will learn about the remaining topics of the formatting bar, like what is alignment and its different types. What is font color and why do we use it? What is highlighting color and why do we use it? What is background color and how and why do we use it? And we will also learn about using bullets and numbering and about why we need to use these. Let us first learn about alignment. Can you say what is alignment and how many types of alignments are there? Alignment is an important part of formatting using which we can set our text or paragraph according to our requirements. We can set the place from where we want to begin typing our text on the page using alignment. By this, I mean that you decide whether you want your text to come on the left side of the page, the right side, or do you want to have it in the center of the page. Alignment is of four types: left alignment, right alignment, center alignment, and justify alignment. Let us now learn about how we use alignment. So first, we will learn about left alignment. By using the left alignment option, we can ensure that our text and paragraph gets typed from the left side of the page. Whatever text or paragraph you type will appear on the left side. In a writer file, left alignment is actually pre-selected. So, using the writer, as soon as you start typing, it gets typed from left side and the cursor also appears on the left side. The shortcut command for this is Ctrl plus L. Learn about this now by watching the video being shown. With the help of this video, we will now learn how to use left alignment. You can left align your text either before typing the text or even after typing the text by selecting it. In the writer sheet, normally your left alignment is automatically selected, which means that when you start typing, your text appears left aligned, as is being shown in the video. By using center alignment, you can get your text or paragraph centered in the page, or by using this option, you can start typing from the center of the page. We can use center alignment for writing the heading or title also. The shortcut command for this is Ctrl plus E. Now learn about this by watching the video. Watch this video to understand how we can use center alignment. Note that before typing the text or even after typing the text, you can use the center alignment. The center alignment shortcut command is Ctrl plus E. You notice that the cursor is blinking. Now, if you want to do center alignment, you will take your pointer in the format bar to the center alignment option and click with your left button on the mouse or the touchpad. And you will notice that the cursor starts blinking in the center of your writer sheet. Now, when you type, your text is aligned to the center of the writer's sheet. Any text that you're typing becomes centered in the writer sheet. Using right alignment, you can bring your text or paragraph on the right side of the page. When you select the right alignment option, your typed text will begin appearing on the right, or whatever you have typed will come to the right side from the left side. The shortcut command for right alignment is Ctrl plus R. You can make use of alignment formatting by selecting your text or even without selecting the text. Now learn about this by watching the video. This video shows us how we can use right alignment to type our text on the right side of the writer sheet. The shortcut command for this is Ctrl plus R. Watch the video. You have already learned left alignment and center alignment. And now we will just press enter once so that the cursor comes in the center. After this, either before typing or after typing, you can set the right alignment. So go to the format bar, take your pointer there and click with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad on right alignment. You will notice that the cursor moves to the right side of the writer page When you start typing here, your text starts appearing from the right end and going towards the left. So this is how you can use right alignment in the writer text. We use justify alignment to make all the lines appear similar. These will start at the same place at the left and end at the same place in the right. By selecting the justify alignment, all lines will become similar and the text or paragraph will come to the left side of the page. The shortcut command for this is Ctrl plus J. Now learn about this by watching the video. Let us watch this video and learn about justify alignment. Justify alignment will make all your lines on the writer page appear similar and they will be left aligned. The shortcut command for this is Ctrl plus J. So to do this, first of all, as is being shown in the video, select the text which is written there by using Ctrl plus A. Then in the format bar, take your pointer to the justify alignment option and click with the left button on the mouse or the touchpad. And you will notice that all your text gets aligned towards the left and all the lines are same. Next, all of you delete all the text that appears on this page. Now, type out quickly the paragraph shown to you and select the paragraph after it has been typed. You will be formatting this paragraph. Bullets and numbering is an option which we use to insert an important line or heading with a symbol and a number. Bullets option has many different kinds of bullets which are like symbols. With the help of this video, we will learn how we can insert bullets or numbers in front of our line or paragraph. With the help of this video, we will now learn how bullets and numbering can be inserted in the writer text. Watch the video carefully. Now, if you want to insert the numbers or bullets, you have to bring the pointer to the beginning of the line or the text and click with your mouse or button once. Now you can go to the format bar and choose the option for bullets. So when you are there, click with your mouse or the touchpad using the left button and a bullet gets inserted and also a bullet toolbar opens up. Now here, as is being shown in the video, if you go and click with the left button at this place, you will see that a window opens about bullets and numbers. If you select the bullets by clicking on it, you will see a different types of bullets are available for you to choose from. So you have to select the one which you like and then press the OK by clicking on it, and you will notice that your bullet changes to the one that you have chosen. Now let's go to the next line or the next paragraph and try to do the numbering also. Now if you want to insert the numbers or bullets, you have to bring the pointer to the beginning of the line or the text. Click on the numbering option in the format bar and you will notice that a number appears where you want it, and also the numbering toolbar, the bullets and numbering toolbar opens. If you click here, as is being shown in the video, again The window opens, showing you different types of bullets and numbering. So you go to the numbering types, you see that there are number of different types available. Different outlines are available. Even different graphics are available. So you have to select the one which you like, which you want. And click on the OK button. First you have to select that by clicking on it, and then you have to click the OK button. Now if you come to the third paragraph beginning, or wherever you want the numbers, you just click on the numbers and the same numbers will appear. If you bring your cursor to the end of the first paragraph and press enter, automatically another bullet will appear. Similarly, if you are in the numbering option and if you click enter, another number will appear by default. In the last paragraph, if we click enter, another number will appear by default there. So this is the way that in your writer you can use bullets and numbers. Font color helps you to change the color of the text. With the help of the video, let us learn how we can change the color of a line or a paragraph. With the help of this video, let us now learn how we can change the color of our writing or the font color. To do this, first select the entire page or text or paragraph that you want to change the font color. You can select the whole paragraph by the shortcut command Ctrl plus A. Once you have selected, go to the format bar and you will find the letter A written. Click on the drop down and a window opens. Now you can select any color of your choice. Click on that with your mouse or touchpad and you will notice that the color of the writing changes. If you want to change the color again, you have to repeat the process. Let us now learn about highlighting color. Highlighting color option is used to change the color behind the written text and not of the text itself. You can use highlighting color to change the color of the entire line or paragraph, even if you have given some spaces in between. Watch this video carefully and learn the method of using highlighting color option. With this video, we will learn how to highlight the text in our paragraph or text. We will first need to select the text that we need to highlight, and you can do that with either the shortcut command Ctrl plus A or using the mouse and the touchpad, or with the arrow keys and the shift key. So once you select the text, then look for in the format bar, look for an option saying AB and click on the drop down with the left button of your mouse or touchpad. Select the color that you want to highlight, use for highlighting, and once you select, you will notice that the text gets highlighted with that color. You have been taught the method to remove this already. As you all know well by now, to format any line or paragraph, you must first select that line or paragraph. To select, you can use either the touchpad or mouse or the arrow keys or the shortcut command. Come, let us now learn about how to change the background color. We use both background color and highlighting color to change the color behind the text. However, there is a small difference in both methods. With highlighting color, you can change the background color of the text till where you have written the text. In comparison, by using the background color option, the background color of the entire paragraph or page will be changed. You do not need to select any text in this option and just need to keep your cursor in the area that you want to change the background color of. Now learn about this by watching the video. With the help of this video, let us learn how we can change the background color. So to change the background color, first select the line, text or paragraph as is shown in the video, and then in the format bar, almost towards the end, there is an option which is for background color. Bring your pointer here and click with the mouse or the touchpad left button and a window opens. You can select the color that you want and you will notice that your background color of the text or the line or the paragraph has been changed. We will end today's class here. Now, all of you close your writer file, and if you face any problems in closing, watch the video and learn. In order to close the writer file, so take your pointer or the cursor to the top right corner where there is a cross sign and click on that with the mouse or the touchpad using the left button. You see three options appearing in a window. Since you do not want to save right now, you can say discard, which is the middle option. Click on that with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad, and your file, writer file, gets closed. Next, shut down your computer properly. In today's class, you have learned some more about the formatting toolbar, like highlighting paragraphs, background color, changing the color of the writing, alignment, left, right, center, and justify, and about bullets and numbering. Thank you.